G'day subscribers, you're probably asking, so I haven't been doing many videos lately. I've been busy working on this radio. Obviously there's a bit of a flu going around, a global one, which is being a bit of a disruption. So just a quick update, I got a fault with the the segments out, or a couple of segments out, whatever. So, I still haven't changed the electrolytics. I got them noted down to change, but I've been chasing this fault with no transmit audio on AM. I have able to source the fault. I thought I might share it with you. Might make it helpful for others out there. So it's the audio is still quite not up to scratch, but I'll give you a demo. I do have a receiver radio on. Check 1 2 1 2. So I'm just getting close to the receive radio so you can hear it. It's a little muffled. 1 2 1 2. You can probably hear a little bit muffly. Don't worry about the hum. Just got a little bit of hum from the fluoro light. Check 1 2 1 2. So yeah, a little muffled. And that's an improvement over no audio at all. So what I found was the problem, which still needs a little bit of treatment. I was hoping to be able to get it to lose the audio, and then I could show you how I found the fault. But it's not going bad again. So where the fault was right here. Let's see if I can turn a light on. Do I have a light on here? No, that light's not going to come on. So the fault was right here. Right there. It's a bit hard to zoom in. Camera's not going to zoom in on it, is it? See if I can white balance it. It's not going to white balance. There we go. It's probably the best I can get it. Yeah, there we go. That's pretty good. It's going to white balance it. That's not going to do it. There you go. I was able to white balance it. So it's right here. Was the fault. If I tapped on there, the audio came good, which incidentally is right really close to the AM regulator there. So what should have occurred to me is that look how shiny the solder joints are here, and here they're a little bit tarned, so a little bit dry, and just tapping here and it came good. So with this junker radio, I suspected, and it should have been obvious, but on the case, I'm going to flip the case over, you can see some obvious signs of rust there on both sides. That's pretty obvious there. And if I get the other case, it's not so bad, but yeah, there you go, there's a little bit more there, but you can see. So I suspect this radio, wherever it came from, was in maybe a junkyard or an open window, and the back of the radio filled up full of water, and all these connections are going to need reworking. So I'll do that, and hopefully the audio is good. I'm back again. Then it's time to address some of the other issues, like the LCD display and probably a couple other things there. So that's the update on the old PC. So yeah, hopefully it'll avoid the junk pile. Thanks for watching, and I'll do an update sooner than you think.